have information, furthermore, our information about the Keep the Child program. So, my companion came from Southern Advent College, and I have a lot of questions, sir. But before that, let me ask you, sir, about your name.
Again, good afternoon, good afternoon, sir. So I am Tomas Andrewobas Jr., teacher 1 at Union National High School. I am teaching grade 9, around Patatuna, Chilino 9, Teddy 9, and ASP 9. So I've been working for about 5 years
now. Okay, sir. So since we are now in the K-12 program, sir, the new curriculum, so is it okay to say, sir, that I'm going to ask you some questions?
Sure.
All right, sir. So our first question is, those are, how did you able to assess the learnings of your students?
So your question is, how am I able to assess the learning of my students? So as a teacher, so first thing we do is we have to give them motivation, you know, prior to discussion, you have to give some activities, you know, about their previous learning. And then after that, we have to discuss and then give some activities. And then after that, we give them assessment, you know, through evaluation. So we give them, so there are a lot of kind of assessment. So we have training exam, we have performance exam. So depending na to, but in home case, so how am I to assess the learning? So siguro, I will give them a written exam, so to assess to get their learning from the lesson.
Oh, since you are talking about the learning, sir, so what are those tools, sir, that you are help you that to assess the learning of the students?
Tools? So, you mean strategies?
Yes, sir, that's right.
Strategies, so this end, so there are a lot of strategies. So now that you know about, you know, student teaching collaboration, now going for tutoring, so there are a lot of strategies. So, and those strategies, benefits, you know, both students and teachers. Because in learning, so I do believe that learning is collaborative. No, teamwork ni siya kayo. Wala pa niyong learning kung wala po na mga bata. So teamwork ni siya. So dapat mag-tinabangay ang teachers o ka students.
Alright, sir. So, a third question, sir, is, are you free more about the teacher curriculum? Is it negative or positive for you, sir?
Both negative and positive, but I am in favor of K-12 because why? It is additional 2 years high school. So sa una kami junior high school, pero nang K-12, siguro ang benefit na is ang bata, kanang maka-gain siya skills, di ba? Sa senior high, naman tayo mga strand, di ba sir? Mga strand. So, sa pamakingan na, so ang bata, paano siya maka-earn of skills, learning, kung makatabang po niya sa iya future po ko, no? Ana.
So, that will be all, sir. Thank you so much for your presentation.
So, my name is Armanes Anghoy with my companion. So, we are here from Philippine Advent College. So, this time I'm going to have some questions like interviewing about the learning styles part about the curriculum. I think Ma'am Loides is already ready, so please state your name first, ma'am. Your positions.
Hello everyone, good afternoon and welcome to Union National High School. I am Mrs. Loida Bidigamo, teaching senior high school department, teaching a senior high school department, and I am the advisor of grade 11 SMAU this year. No? Teacher 3, almost 10 years this coming May in my service, and happy to serve the DepEd. No? And I've been here also at Union since the time that the time of employment. So 10 years ako in this institution. So
without further ado, our first question now is goes on like this. How did you able to assess the learnings of your students, ma'am?
Okay, having this K-12 curriculum in which all of us know that this curriculum is dead, no? Practice. So having this kindergarten up to senior high school level in our education is much better, I think, than the other curriculum, because in our case, no, having this senior high school is a preparatory course for them before they will enroll at college. So having this preparatory course, teachers are very confident in having these students to really be prepared in themselves before they will enroll at college.
So, as a teacher, ma'am, what are your strategies or tools you use to assess the learnings?
First and foremost, no, as we start, or before I will start my class, I situate that I conduct a diagnostic test, a pre-test, or diagnostic test, for me to know if the students has this, the so-called prior knowledge, no, before introducing the subject to them. Then, as educator, it is a protocol for us to lay down our lesson plan. A teacher must have a lesson plan before going to class. So in conducting a class, or that's it, diagnostic test, and then after diagnosing the knowledge of the students, that's the time that we will motivate them to learn and let them guess. So let them guess of what is the topic for today, why it should, why they are here today. So show them what after having the topic, so next to that is you have to show to them what are the objectives to be done for that particular hour. Okay, diba? We are in the classroom for 1 hour, it's the subject. Okay.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. So since we are now in your curriculum, ma'am, the people trial, so what are those you like about the Kikutrol and Gunatlan? So let's start about the dislike.
Dislike?
Dislike
of that? Okay, so dislikes about K-12, honestly speaking, the approach, because in K-12, we have this math-based instruction in which really made the teacher's guide are there. The teachers has no choice but to follow what is in the guide, and then by following those guides, sometimes the reading is not priority. The reading is not priority anymore. That is why, in my observation, students nowadays are the students are not fond of reading anymore, because it is not anymore their habit. Just like unlike before, 3 hours are being integrated into class. So this time, focus on the MELC, MELC, and then which is reading is not that priority. So as you can observe, college students doesn't know how to read, and worse, doesn't know how to interpret what they are reading.
That's great. How about do you like
this? The advantage of having this K-12 curriculum is that students are prepared before they are going to enroll in college. And then another advantage of having this K-12 is that learner-centered. We teachers act only as facilitators of the learning. We are the one who will give instruction, and then an example, at least 1-2 examples, and then let the students do the activity either by group or individual.
So that would be all, ma'am. So thank you so much for your brilliant.
afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Okay.
So I'm here to interview you, ma'am. So this afternoon, I am Armanes Anghoy from the Philippine Anton College. So in order to have our access or our outcomes this afternoon, so that's why we choose you, ma'am, as our interview.
So thank you very much for choosing me as one of your interviewees.
So before anything else, I want you to come to this state
Hi everyone, so I'm teacher Lovely Yudumahil from Gunya National High School. So at Gunya National High School, I'm teaching in the senior high school department.
Okay, ma'am, so let's start without further ado. My first question, ma'am, is how did you able to assess the learning of your students, ma'am?
Okay, so as a teacher, I'm going to give post-test in every topic that we discuss or any additional activities, so that using the higher order thinking skills of my students, so that I can know if they understand our lesson well.
Thank you, ma'am. So second question is, what are those instructional materials, ma'am, or tools have you used to assess their learning?
Okay, so aside from giving them post-test, so I prepare activity sheets and any related materials to assess them well.
So, since we are now in the new curriculum, the G2Trial, so what are those you like now in the G2Trial?
Okay, so in G2Trial curriculum, I like the learning process of the students, so wherein they are required to engage in all or in every activities that we have. So they are learned and they are prepared in the real life scenario.
So how about your G2Trial, ma'am, in the
K-12? Okay, so in this K-12 curriculum, so I observed that during the implementation of this program, there are many students who are promoted in higher level, even they could hardly read or understand. So as a senior high school student, a teacher, I always expect that they have developed their higher thinking skills, can read and write well, but during this time, there are many students who did not be at that level. So maybe because of the presentation of the subject matter, wherein the students are much focused on having fun, not on the learning process at all.
All right, so good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
All right, so my name is Arman S. Anghoy, PhD student, came from Sindangan. You'll not make it too long, ma'am. So I have here some questions that I think you can answer this one. So, but before that, beside me is my former teacher here in Gunya National High School, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon to our aspiring teachers in the future. First and foremost, I would like to introduce myself. I am Mary Luz Byron Albocatis of Gunya National High School. I am a advisor of grade 8, science teacher, ESP coordinator, and a school governing council secretary. It is my pleasure to be interviewed by my former student, Arman Anghoy, sir.
Okay, so shall we start, ma'am?
Yes.
So my first question is, as a teacher, ma'am, how did you able to assess the learnings of your students?
All right, so to assess the learning of our student after the lesson and the discussion that we have, we give them formative assessment such as oral recitation or a quiz, and we will get the mastery level of the class. And for those students who are not able to do good performance, we give them remedial classes to assist them.
That's good.
Yes.
Okay. Second is, what are those instructional materials or tools have you used in assisting their learning?
Okay, so as a teacher of science, I give them video lesson, learning activity sheets, charts, and models to assess their learning.
So in science terms, we use models when
we assess.
Yes,
we do.
Yes,
that's charts.
Yes. Since we're now in the curriculum, like K-12, what are those advantages do you see in the program of the K-12?
Okay, so the program K-12 curriculum, it is more on exploratory of the student. It is a performance-based and a student-centered curriculum. It includes the student's own experiences, and they are ready to be a globally competitive.
So the students are able to motivate by themselves.
Yes.
So you revealed, ma'am, that you are on your favorite advantages.
Yes.
No more questions about the advantages. So my last question, ma'am, is what is your personal suggestion on how to improve the curriculum implementation?
Okay, so teachers' development, we need to involve or register or to attend seminars, webinars, workshops, and trainings to uplift and update the learning strategies that we're going to use in the students and to be professionally grown.
All right, so what Ma'am Lu's trying to share us is, even though we are professional, we're trying to socialize.
Yes.
All right.
To grow,
to adapt,
to grow in every century.
Okay, thank you, Ma'am Lu, for a very brilliant
thank you.
Yes.